Namaste. Welcome to this very special program. We are in conversation with His Holiness, Pujya Shri Shri Shantananda Puri Mahaswamiji of Vashishta Guha in Himalayas. On behalf of all of you, our pranams to Pujya Swamiji and welcome you to this program.
Thank you, Madam.
Swamiji, can you tell us about the Vashishta Gufa?
Yes. A friend of mine who is a teacher somewhere nearer to Badrinath, or rather Kedarnath, he happened to find out from the Uttarakhand Mahatmya, perhaps from Padma Purana or something, he brought three shlokas. There it is mentioned, I went to the Vashistha Guha before going to Devaprayag. Devaprayag is 42 kilometers from Vashistha Guha. So obviously he is meaning this only. It is told there that I went there, I met the great sage Vashistha. And from there I came to Devaprayag and I saw and I had the darshan of Sri Ram. It is told like that. So obviously this Guha is very, very old, it is natural and it is associated with a lot of miraculous glories. For example, the Guha, when you go, it's fairly quite long enough. At the end, there is a Shivalinga which has been installed within the last 200 years only. But behind that, there is a small wall. You will find a small hole. I am told this hole was big enough for a person to pass through in the earlier days. And it goes 20 kilometers beyond up to a place called Ghantakarna Mandir, up above in the Himalayas. But now the ways from both sides are not traceable like. And here I was told in 1946 or 47, as some lady tried to go inside the cave, just you know, crawling through with two torches in her hand, and she was afraid when she heard some hissing sound that there could be some serpents. But she was able to see after about a little furlong. The cave was as big as in the beginning side, it was very wide and it was going for a long distance. But she was afraid, she came back. My Guruji, His Holiness Swami Purushottamananda Maharaj, didn't want that normal mortal should tread that path. The reason being, according to him, there were a number of perfect souls, we call them as Siddha Purushas, who were in their Adrishya Rupa, that is, they were in the subtle form where there was no body visible outside. And they are people who have attained the highest, but like the Bodhisattvas, they wanted to help the world before they completely identified themselves with the cosmic totality. And it is told that a good number of them are there still and they are trying to influence the life led in the world by various people to the extent possible. And very miraculous incidents happen. There is one great sage at present who is known as Swami Dayananda Saraswati, His Holiness Swami Dayananda Saraswati. He has one ashram at Rishikesh, he has a Vedanta college near Coimbatore in a place called Anagatti. He happened to come there in 1996 along with his photographer. He took a photo of that small platform at the very end where the Shivalinga was installed. And there was nothing unique about it. But he went back and got that photo developed, he found that there were two big streams of light coming from the top of the Shivalinga, going parallel by the side wall, which is a small wall, going up above in the ceiling, and intertwining themselves into circles and loops, and going that length, and going to that other wall, which was long, starting from the entrance to the cave. It went parallel, and then it disappeared into the earth just before the entrance, much before the entrance. He sent us two copies of those photographs. They are available with the Swamiji who is in charge there. And I also put a photo of it in my book called as Fragrant Flowers, which contains some of my memories.
Can you also tell us about your experiences of staying in the Guha?
The point is, I never chose. I was chosen. I was going somewhere to Shivanandaji Maharaj, with whom I had a long time contact. I was going from time to time for satsang. I was placed in Meerut in those days. And somebody was sitting by my side. He drew me into conversation, and he was later on transferred. He was a manager in the Escorts Limited, named Prithik Singh Patania from the Himachal Pradesh. He said, "Sir, you have been going several times to Shivananda Ashram. Why don't you come along with me?" "Where to?" He said, "There is one Vashishta Guha and Swami Purushottamananda is there." That's how I was taken. So I didn't choose. I was chosen, and I liked it. It was love at first sight when I saw my Gurudev, who was at that time about 79 years old or something like that. The first question he asked me was, "Hey, you have known me since 1952. How is it you are coming so late?" It was 1956 when I went to him. I've heard about him. I mean, his name was mentioned, one of the souvenirs of Shivanandaji Maharaj. I tried my best. I couldn't locate him at that time because he has written. Even today, there are masters who have come face to face with the Supreme Lord, and he has mentioned two names. One was my Gurudev's. Other one was one Krishna Prem Maharaj, who was known as Ronald Nixon. And that's how I came there. And as regards my experiences, it's a wonderful place full of vibrations, where Paramahansa Yogananda, of the fame of autobiography Yogi, had been there, it seems. And Swami Ramtirtha had been there. Papa Ramdas of Kanjagad had been there. So, and we don't know how many pure souls earlier had gone there and left the footprints of their vibrations for the posterity to enjoy and to come up in that spiritual line. At the moment you sit there, you find yourself so elevated, the mind becomes zero-like, and you are in an ecstasy, almost a stage of meditation to which you could come by ardent practice for several years elsewhere, say in our own house and all that. And it has not been the experience of myself alone. Several people had their experience, several people had visions. There is a lady from Holland, 25 years old. She was going somewhere, then the taxi driver told, "Would you care to visit? There's a cave." She came down and she was sitting inside. I didn't know about it. My room was in the backside, facing the Ganges. But she was there when we were in the dining hall. When she saw me talking to people in English, she said, "Oh, Swamiji, you speak English. I saw there your Gurudev left his body in February 1961. Have you met him since?" The question was not, it looked mysterious. She herself says he had left his body in 1961, and she is asking me, "Have you met him since?" I just said no and kept quiet. She followed me to my room after washing her hands. She said, "I want to share my experience which I had now here." She was just sitting inside in meditation. Suddenly she opened her eyes to see that my Gurudev was standing. How did she know? Just in the entrance, on one of the platforms, you have a big photo that is called the Gaddi. So there is a photo of my Gurudev. He found him standing before with a long stick in his hand. There is no photo there with a long stick, but he used to have one. And the moment she saw, she said, this seems to be some hallucination or an illusion like, because just now I saw his photo, perhaps he is standing before me. He divined her thoughts and he said, child, I am as true as you are. I am not an illusion. I am as true as you are. She was taken aback. And then he asked her, what do you want? This used to be a stock question with many people. What do you want? She said, Swamiji, I want jnana. He laughed uproariously and disappeared. This is what she told.
Namaste to everyone. I am Yogi Himanshu, founder of Himalayan Yoga Association in Rishikesh, India. So today we have come to Vashistha Ashram. This is very popular place and we believe, as all of you are yoga practitioners, so if you visit Rishikesh, you must see this place. Vashistha Ashram is located in Rishikesh on the bank of the River Ganga. Whole ashram is surrounded by beautiful nature, and this story of Yogi Vashistha, how he lived his life, it is very inspiring for every individual. By knowing this story, we can also live ego-free. So Yogi Vashistha is son of the god Brahma. In India, we call Yogi Vashistha Chiranjeevi, which means he is immortal. So he is not mortal, even though he leaves his body, but still his soul stays in this place to protect this place. So once upon a time, a demon, he killed all his son. So to give up his internal pain of losing his son, to give up his grief, he and his wife, both they visited Rishikesh to perform the meditation. Before they decided to give up their life in the Ganges, but the mother Ganges could not accept it because they were such a divine person, and Mother Ganga, she wanted them to live throughout the life. So therefore they decided to live here. They lived in a cave, and rest of their life they completely practiced yoga and they spent their whole life in austerity. This is very uplifting, this is very inspiring story. We hope you enjoy this beautiful atmosphere, this beautiful, energetic, powerful ashram. And whenever you visit Rishikesh, make sure to visit this place. And I wish you all a wonderful day, wonderful time. Stay healthy, stay safe, keep practicing yoga. Namaste, thank you.
Evidence reveals that Jesus spent much of his lost years in India. This is more of that story. In the foothills of the Himalayas on the Ganges River, about an hour upriver from Rishikesh, is a cave called Vashishta Guha. Made famous by the ancient sage Vashishta, it has been a home for yogis for centuries, most recently the renowned Swami Purushottamananda. About a 5-minute walk downriver from this cave is another cave known as the Jesus Cave. Set in the side of a sheer cliff on the banks of the Ganga, the cave has a spectacular view of the river and the surrounding peaks of the Himalayas. The cave derived its name from the tradition that Jesus spent time there during his sojourn in India during the so-called lost years. In the last century, both Swami Ramatirtha and Papa Ramdas lived there at separate times and had visions of Jesus meditating there, though they had no prior knowledge of his having lived there. Monks from our ashram had the good fortune to visit and meditate in this cave during a pilgrimage to India in 2003. For more information, read The Christ of India at ocoy.org.
Without